shift up what you want to do on the playbook.
Yeah, definitely. Change what you're doing in the playbook, but boy, the advantage shifts to the guys on defense, doesn't it? Longer yardage situations, they often become bolder.
From the gun, it's Brady. He couldn't quite hold it. Got hit. Ball pops out, incomplete.
Normally, he's pretty reliable. Usually catches what's thrown to him. On that play, he simply dropped it.
Now Brady throwing on second down. It's caught outright, Amendola. It'll be a pickup of 15 as that'll lead to third down. Short of the sticks after that completion, and now it's third down for this offense. And quickly, they get to the line. From the gun on third down, Brady. And he dropped it. Now it was tipped. Altered the ball a little bit, but he dropped it. And now fourth down.
There are a good number of coaches that any time they call an in route are really worried about the play because there's so much traffic ordinarily that the ball has to get through to get to the receiver. And on that play, it was batted down.
He gets this one away, and boy, it's another boomer. Great coverage there. Holds him to a 2-yard return following a 50-yard punt. And it'll be Seahawk football as they take over deep in their own territory. Now we'll see what this Seahawks offense has in store with their first possession of the second half. They were able to get the stop defensively. Now a chance really to set the tone here in quarter three.
They can really take charge, can't they? And this is probably how it was drawn up at the half. I think we can go inside the locker room, all right? And I think we would see up on the grease boards, stop them defensively, get the ball back for the offense, and let's go downfield and score. Seems simple, right? The last part, we have to find out if that's going to happen. But the first part worked to perfection. Did exactly what they wanted, and now their offense has to pay it off.
See if they can get the latter 50%. They'll run it now out of the gun. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. A nice pickup there of 11 yards, and it'll move the sticks. And a new set of downs here after picking up the first on the ground.
Well, so much for him being bottled up throughout the day. Finally finds a way to break through and get a really nice gain. The defense had felt great about what they had going. Now they've got to turn their attention to getting it back in that direction. Can they bottle him up again? Because I'd say after that run, confidence is pretty high for him. Well, coaches always talk about finding balance on offense. I don't think you can get much more balance than this. Big time run. Big time pass.
A 1-2 combination. Looked pretty good.
How about that? Let's see if they can continue to take that kind of a punch, though.
He's going to find his running back. It's complete. And he's going to get this inside the 30. It'll go as a gain of 10 there. And that'll be good for a Seattle first down.
We always talk about having to read defenses and how complicated that is. Well, this was an excellent read. Read the pressure and got rid of the football before it even got to him for a nice game.
And when they're blitzing like that, running back usually a good spot to go with the football?
Without a doubt, because he's right in your sight line or he's near you. So you're able to just get it to him easily. And once he gets in space, that's usually a good matchup for him. He decided to run a hitch route. It really helped have a guy who can turn it loose. And boy, he rifled one in there on that one. Not much run after catch, but it worked really well.
And he's brought down just outside of the 10 at the 11. A nice pickup there, 10 yards, and it'll move the sticks. So the run moves the chains, and here we go on first down.
For so many years, I was convinced it was a myth, you know, because you always hear about the smaller running back. Like, it's lost, you can't find him, and sometimes that's part of his genius. But it's true. You get behind big offensive. Line guys trying to find him, trying to peek around people to see him, and he gets lost. But this guy gets lost in a good way for his offense, picking up big yardage.
Offense walks to the line for play number 7 of the drive. They'll run it now out of the gun, and they go the wrong way on this one, losing yardage back at the 12. It's a loss of 2, now third down. Ninth play of the drive coming up, and certainly not an easy one on third and long.
What a tremendous play by the defensive line. Instead of getting too far upfield against the drop, able to hold their spot and make a big play in the backfield.
And he's able to get it down to the 2-yard line. Give him 10 yards on the pickup, and that's going to make it fourth down. So out comes the field goal team once more. From the left hash, you'll have to cut this at a tight angle. And Hauschka's kick is good. And they take the lead here by two, 12-10. So another drive bogs down there, but for the fourth time here, they're able to escape with at least 3 points.
And this last one gives them the lead, so they've needed all of these field goals to be in the position they are.
Now after the made field goal, Hauschka back out onto the field to kick it away. This fielded at the two. And he'll get it up just past the 20, and his guys will go to work at the 21-yard line. Now the Patriots offense, they work their way back out onto the field, and they're coming off a three and out, my friend.
I think they've got to look at that play sheet and go to a spot that they haven't gone before. Time to shake things up a little bit to try and get this offense moving.
Okay, so how do you do that? How do you shake things up?
You look at what you called before, realize it hasn't worked
so well. Go to something else.
And maybe try and find one of those special plays from one of your better players, and maybe try and hit something big and get things going in the excitement area.
On first down, Brady. And complete on the right side to Bennett. Just a yard on the catch there. It'll be second and nine. And now they're in the hurry up. This is Lewis. And he'll get this up over the 25 to the 26. It's a 4-yard pickup there, and it leaves him with third and five.
When you find that kind of yardage, you couldn't be more confident as a ball carrier. And guess what? You're going to go back and tell your offensive coordinator, I'd like to keep carrying it, thank you.
Shotgun now for Brady. And he'll have his man. That's Edelman. Oh, he breaks a tackle, and he's got an alley. A big play there on the catch and run. 30 yards.
As we continue to advance in the NFL, as people continue to scout players, they really don't care as much about body types as they care about those guys who can make people miss, run through tackles, and gain all that additional run after catch. Anybody who has that ability, they want them on their team.
So after that big gain, let's see what else the offense has up its sleeve. They go play action here on first down. His throw incomplete. Unable to connect on the first down pass play. Now it's second down. Brady to throw on second down. He's got time in the pocket. Over the middle, it's Amendola. That catch good for only a yard, and it'll be third down. The line to gain is the 33 on third down. And now it looks like they're going to be in the hurry up. Here's Brady. Amendola's got it complete. The completion good for only six, and that'll bring up fourth.
They didn't get the first down, but I have to say, I do like the call. I like what they were trying to do. Try and hit your receiver on the run and see if he can pick it up. Keep it on his feet, get a little rack yardage.
Yeah, but a nice job defensively to get to him and keep him short of the first. That's running out of steam, and it won't get there. He left it just short, no good, and this score will stay right where it is. Thomas Rawls getting ready to go here on offense. And
still second down.
Tight end to the right, boy. Tight end to the right. Move. Good.
Following the penalty, it's Rawls. And nowhere to run on the interior of that defensive line. He'll get back only to the line of scrimmage.
Well, he didn't make headway on that one, but he's had plenty of carries all night long. I just wonder if maybe he's a little bit tired from toting the rock that much.
A fake to Rawls. Now it's Wilson. Backing up. Going for the deep ball. And that will be caught. But out of bounds. bounds. Out of bounds, ruled incomplete here. A third down, he tried to stay in bounds, did all he could. He caught it, but was led a little bit too far.
Yeah, and that's always difficult, isn't it? Because you know half of your body is trying to stay behind while the other half is reaching out, trying to catch the football. The top half worked. It was the bottom half that was in question.
And this will be out of bounds at the one here, the 12-yard line. And the Seahawks defense working their way back out onto the field. Now, the last time out, Charles, they held strong, forced a field goal, which was missed. And that's kind of the difference in the game right now. Look at the scoreboard.
It is. It's a very slim lead that they still possess. So a lot of people would think that they'd be pretty nervous on that side of the ball. Boy, you're just kind of hanging in there. Instead, I think because of what you referenced, holding them the last time, forcing the missed field goal, that gives them a lot of confidence, and they feel like they can go out there and do it again.
And he is going to lose yardage here. A loss of a full 3 yards, and now it's second down.
All right, Brandon, you know me as well as anyone. You know I don't usually advocate abandoning things during a game, but here we are in the second half. I think it's time to change things up. Let the running game go a little bit. Let's get to the passing game. And if you still want to get in the hands of the runner, maybe swing it to him, throw it to him a little bit. Try it that way.
They give him 13 yards there on the play and a fresh set of downs. They're going to hurry back to the line now. Brady going to throw and almost intercepted. It would have been his second pick of the game. Instead, it'll be second down. Second down now after the incompletion. Now Brady. And he's got his favorite target yet again. It's complete. And he's brought down, getting this one up to about the 35. And with that last play, he's now up over that 300-yard mark.
And in today's NFL, it almost feels routine. And I hate that when you talk about a 300-yard passing game. To me, 300 yards still signifies excellence, and he's achieved that in this performance.
Here's Brady to throw. And almost intercepted. It would have been his second pick of the game. Instead, it'll be second down. He's lucky to be getting that one back.
After what they've done with him all day long, with all the targets trying to go after him, he's obviously gotten smart, and his pride has kicked in. Made a terrific play.
Looking back to the air on second down, it's Brady. And this time he's got the hookup. It's complete. A big play there for New England. 49 yards.
There will always be a place for methodically marching the ball downfield. But when you can pick it up in big chunks and strike like that, have explosive plays, that's often the difference in winning and losing. Those types of plays that can knock a defense off balance, that'll drive a team towards a victory.
And now a first down following that long game. Into the red zone, it's Brady. That is caught, and he's in. Touchdown, Patriots. Nick Vanette, a 15-yard touchdown grab. And once again, the Patriots are back out in front. Boy, it's nice to have that big, reliable target you can go to.
Each and every time. A lot of people see that position as a fallback. Throw it to them when all else fails. Not at all. This guy can make plays, and that's exactly what he just did.
Yeah, play here for a touchdown. Into the red zone, it's Brady. That is caught, and he's in. Touchdown.
Complimentary football comes into play. How do I take care of my defense? How do I take care of my offense? Well, the defense is taking care of them in a lot of ways. Now it's time for the offense to check things up and help their defense out. Give them a little bit of rest.
Yeah, time for them to give them a rest. Took the words right out of my mouth. It's caught outright by Graham. Give them 11 yards that time and a new set of downs.
That coach is always harp on the quarterback reading the defense and getting it to the open man. That's good recognition there. And how about what he did after the catch?
Yeah, hit your tight end. Let him get some rack.
Yeah, when he gets moving, not many guys want to come over and put a hit on him, do they?
hostile offense. Still first down.
Graham slotted out to the left. From the gun, it's Wilson. And Graham's got it over the middle. It'll be a pickup of 10 yards. And it'll bring up a second down.
When you execute a drag or a crossing route really well and give them a chance to let it develop a little bit, you can gain some significant yardage hitting your tight end on that one.
So they complete the pass, and now they face a second down. Rawls, the lone man in the backfield. On second down, Wilson. Oh, he's got a man wide open, complete. They pick up 12 on the play there, and they move the chains. So the offense has it first and 10. Now Wilson on first down. Complete out right to Kurz. Give him 27 yards that time. And it's good enough for a Seattle first. They come out here in the eye. Now a play fake here on first down. And no escaping this time as he'll go down. They got him for a sack. Well, this has been a pretty sizable drive. They've had some success. Finally, the defensive coordinator found some success of his own.
I think he just simply said enough of that. Look at it, moved the ball well. We need to force the issue from our end, and that's exactly what he did.
Now we've got whistles and movement up front. I think this is against Seattle.
Postal offense. Still second down.
Now Wilson on second down. And they can't get the long connection as it falls incomplete. And here comes play number 6 on this drive. And some secondary help here for the defense and the nickel on third and long. Third and long, it's Wilson. And he'll be hit as he releases it, and that'll fall incomplete. So on fourth down, out trots the kicker in a big spot here. They'll put it down right at the 40, so call this a 50-yard attempt. And his kick is good. Boy, just did tuck it into the bottom of that left corner. And that will cut the lead down to just 2. So yet another field goal to end the drive. That has been a very common theme. He's now hit 5 of them in this game.
Yeah, Brandon, as an offense, you hate that you've had to call on your kicker so often, but you have to love the fact that time and time again, he's come through.
So yet another field goal to end the drive. That has been a very common theme. He's now hit 5 of them in this game.
Yeah, Brandon, as an offense, you hate that you've had to call on your kicker so often, but you have to love the fact that time and time again, he's come through.
Now after the main field goal, Hauschka back out onto the field to kick it away. This is taken at the 3. Solid return, pretty good field position. They'll start at the 32-yard line. And the Patriots gearing up to go now. And they'll just simply be looking to build off the confidence of the last time out where they scored a touchdown.
And confidence is powerful, isn't it? When you've scored once, you feel like you can go back out there and get it done again. Doesn't matter what the defense throws at them, they feel like they're in a groove right now, and they want to get out there and show it.
Yeah, hoping to stay in that groove here this go-around. On second down, here's Brady. Over the middle, it's Amendola. And he'll be brought down just shy of midfield at the 49-yard line. Brady now on first down. He's got the tight end, Vanette. That throw good for four. It's second down. And they're going to hurry back to the line now. Brady to throw on second down. Looking for his tight end on the corner. It's complete. And he goes down, but not before getting this inside the 25. And on that last play there, he's over 400 yards passing now.
You know what that generally means?
Success.
That, and it means you really didn't miss opportunities. Usually very accurate. The ball's getting to the right place. Guys are making yardage after the catch to help you out that way. I mean, the whole team has picked it up. And don't forget, that means the offensive line has had to pass protect pretty well, too.
Everyone dialed in. To throw, it's Brady. Sets up the screen to Lewis.
Personal foul. Face mask. Defense.
And I know it's hard in live action, but you've got to keep your hands away from the face. That's a 15-yard penalty.
You work on it all the time, making sure your target area is lower and trying to keep your hands away from the face mask so you don't get the big penalty.
They try again with Lewis. And he'll get about three just outside the 10, stopped at the 11. And in this situation with a lead fourth quarter, they're liking keeping the ball on the ground, I'm sure.
That's just smart football, but you know the defense has to know it as well. They've got to stop them here. So now we're going to see that loading the box in a big way. 6, 7, 8, 9, whatever it's going to take, puts a little bit more pressure on your big offensive line.
It's an 8-yard pickup, and it leads to a first and goal. And they're going to speed things up here. They'll give it to him right up the gut. And he is going to lose yardage here. It's a loss of two there, bringing up second down.
No matter what defense is called versus a running play, linebackers are telling the defensive guys up front, you take care of the offensive line, keep us uncovered, let us run to the ball, we'll make big plays. Well, that paid off there. All the guys up front, the big fellas, they controlled the five offense.
And he'll take this into the end zone. Now, hold on here. We do have a flag down. So let's see what this is about.
Holding offense.
So oftentimes you see defensive holding. Here it's offensive holding for the flag. Now Brady throwing on second down. Now they set up the screen. That's complete. And he'll be brought down this time at the 5-yard line. They'll wind up getting 10 back there. So it'll leave them with a third and five. An extra DB defensively here. Big stop needed on third and goal.
He may be a blitzer.
And that is incomplete. He was looking for Julian Edelman that time. And now it's fourth down.
All defenders get tired of hearing about their lack. Respect to the kicker, like, congratulations, but you do feel pretty good about not giving up anything big.
Yeah, and we'll see if they can not give up anything big on this drive.
I'm wondering if the same thing went through your mind as mine. When I see a big man like that make a catch, all I keep thinking to myself is, big man with football. Look out, everyone. He may not juke you a whole lot, right? He may not run past you because of his size. You talk about a guy weighing in the 270 range. But boy, once he gets his mitts on the ball, he's going to be tough to bring down.
They give him 14 yards that time, and a flash shut it down. And leading here late, so a chance for the defense to really close out this game if they can halt the offense. First and 10, it's Wilson. Wide open receiver complete. And taking it across midfield and inside the 45. And passing yardage-wise, now up over 350 in this game. Pretty nice performance.
Definitely that, which usually means you're putting a lot of pressure on guys trying to cover. If you're a defensive back and they put over 350 yards on you, you've had a long day. The key to everything, if you're doing it without throwing interceptions or turning the ball over.
5 yards on the catch there, brings up second down. Time for a break. We're back to perhaps crown a champion after this. So it's Seahawk football as we march toward a conclusion. And let's see what they've come up with offensively after having time to talk it over. On second down, Wilson. They set up the screen to Rawls. Only a yard there. Sniffed out well defensively, and it brings up third. An extra defensive back in the game now here for third and four. Back to throw. He finds his man, Baldwin. They get 6 on the pickup there as the drive will continue. Looking to speed things up here, going with some tempo. He's back to throw. Surveying the field. And it pops free. The collision there jarred the ball loose and brings up second down. Offense walks to the line for play number 7 of the drive. He'll look to throw. Caught left side, Williams. And taking it to the 15-yard line before he's brought down. And the offense moving quickly to the line. He'll look to throw. Going to Rawls on the dump off. And he will score. Touchdown, Seattle. Thomas Rawls, a 15-yard touchdown grab. And the Seahawks have taken the lead here in the fourth.
And touchdown and congratulations and zero relaxation ahead of them, right? Way too much time on the clock for them to start celebrating.
Yeah, part one is done, but now on the sideline, you can already see them scrambling down there. They're getting those defensive guys ready.
Yes, you have to get those guys ready, and you also have to talk to your special teams guys. Make sure the kickoff is exactly what you want and cover it well.
All right, now a big two-point conversion attempt still to come. Wilson gonna throw for it. And he'll get into the end zone. So now a field goal would only tie as they up their lead to 3. So that effort gives them a 3-point cushion and guarantees that a field goal going forward won't beat them.
Yeah, that's really good strategy because that's all you care about. Not getting beat at this stage. At least give your team a fighting chance.